This garden was acquired about 50 years ago by the present incumbents. The history of it, as I've heard, is that there used to be one gentleman who has planted this tea area part by part over the years. What it looks like now is the outcome of that. Let's understand the tea bush is same all along entire Assam or country or whatever you say. And more or less the tea machinery is same. So what actually is the differentiating factor which makes Halmari stand out? If you see, generally the tea belt in this area would be yielding about, say, anything between 25 to 30 quintals per hectare. But the kind of plucking we do, it is so refined and so delicate plucking we have, that we sacrifice a lot of crop. When we go for quality plucking, and we just pluck tender 2 and a bud or 3 and a bud, it brings our productivity down, both in terms of bush as well as in terms of the worker. So much that we have a, say, average yield level of about 17 to 18 quintals per hectare. So instead of 25, 30 to 17, 18. So that's a crop loss intentionally we have taken on our heads just to produce a good quality. We generally are focused on CTC kind of teas. We do make about 10% of teas as orthodox, that's rolled leaf kind of teas. And in CTC, we have various grades as any other tea a CTC would have. And in both categories, we are very particular about plucking short rounds so that we get the best possible raw material to our factory. One has to go into the minutest details of all nuances of these operations. So that's my job. And once I've seen that end product has been made, and then eventually by evening, I would go and taste the teas as to what work we have done. Are we on the right line? Does it need any change? So it gives me some thoughts to work upon as to does it require any change or not. You just take away. From here, the people are working very hard for you to take this cup of tea and enjoy the next day morning sitting in the nestle of this nature. When you drink tea, there should be a smile on your face.